Hello friends, in this series of how to solve gate question in less than 30 seconds of signal and system, the next topic we have is ROC, that is region of convergence. So let's see the flow. So the flow is, we have three steps. First, you should get x of z. After getting x of z, you can get the region of convergence. After getting that, you can find the x of n. So this is the flow. Now to get x of z, you have to do the partial fraction. That can be the additional step for x of z. See, either x of z would be given in the question as we want, or we have to use the partial fraction and we have to bring that in the form like something plus something. Alright, so first step was that. Then you have to find ROC, and then there are many concepts involved in that, so we will see that also. Then finding x of n means we are doing the inverse z transform. Simple. So let's start. So the first point is, I will talk about the ROC. Suppose I have to find the ROC and I have x of z as z by z minus a, and let's say plus z by z minus b. Then I know that I have this a point, positive a point here. Like, put this is equal to 0, then you will get z is equal to a. Put this is equal to 0, then you will get z is equal to b. Now plot a and b. I assume that b is greater than a, so a would be here, b would be here. Now draw the circles. So this is the case, and see, here we have real part, here we have imaginary part. So u is here, jv is here. This is nothing but real and imaginary. So this is the case. All right now when we talk about region of convergence, we have to cover the whole graph. Now question is, how you can cover the whole graph? First point is, if you have to cover this area, you can say that mod z is less than a. So less than a is this area. Now when mod z is greater than b, means the outer area, correct? So you can cover the outer part, you have covered the inner part. Now the remaining part is this, correct? Now this part is less than b and greater than a. So mod z is less than b and greater than a. So this is nothing but ROC. Alright, now there are some concepts involved, so let's see that. So our three ROC were this: mod z is less than a, mod z is greater than b, mod z is greater than a but less than b. Now for this three ROC, we will get the different x of n. So for this ROC, we will get one x of n, for this ROC, we will get another x of n, for this ROC, we will get another x of n. So how to find that is the next question. Now to solve that, you should understand one rule. Rule is, for less than there is one rule, for greater than there is one rule. Now for less than, the rule is, so for less than, the rule is, the answer should be minus of a raised to n u of minus n minus 1. Now for greater than, the rule is a raised to n u of n, correct? Now this a is nothing but like a b c d, anything. So this is in general like minus a raised to n u of minus n minus 1. For greater, it would be a raised to n u of n. Now look at the question. And first ROC, when we talk about first ROC, it is less than a. Now you know the rule. If you want to convert x of z into x of n, you have to follow this rule only. Like, you have different ROC. ROC 1 is this, ROC 2 is this, ROC 3 is this. Suppose ROC 1 is this, mod z is less than 1, then what would be the answer? X of n would be, for this equation I am saying, x of n would be, whenever you see less, rule is this. So answer would be minus a raised to n u of minus n minus 1 minus b raised to n u of minus n minus 1. Now my second ROC is this, mod z is greater than b. The rule is this. Again, what would be the answer? X of n is equal to a raised to n u of n plus b raised to n u of n. Now ROC is this. Now you have to apply both of the rule in this ROC, because mod z is greater than a. So x of n would be, when we talk about greater, greater is this, correct? Because this is mod z greater, mod z less. So mod z greater is this. So answer would be a raised to n u of n. Then we have mod z less, mod z less. So this is the rule. So answer would be, second term we have is this, correct? For b, this. For a, this. Alright. So second term we have is less, and for less, this would be changed like minus b raised to n u of minus n minus 1. So this is the answer. You can see that for this ROC, answer is different. For this ROC, answer is different. For this ROC, answer is different. So this is the trick I have provided here, and you can solve any gate question using this trick. I guarantee that. So let's see the sum. So the first gate question we have is given as h of z is equal to z by z minus 0.2, ROC is given as mod z less than 0.2, and we have to find the impulse response, that is h of n. So first rule, whenever you see less, what is the rule? Answer should be minus of a raised to n and u of minus n minus 1, correct? Then you can see that a is here 0.2, so answer would be minus of 0.2 raised to n u of minus n minus 1. So the answer for this is nothing but this. I hope you like this, because this is you are solving in less than 30 seconds. Looking at the question, you are writing the answer. Like the options in the questions were 0.2 raised to n u of n, then we have, but if you analyze the options, you can note that your answer was this. All right, I got it. Because of this funda, if less than is present, your generalized equation is this. Instead of a, you are putting 0.2, so the answer would be this. I got this. But when you will get this answer? This answer you will get when mod z is greater than 0.2. Because for that, the generalized equation is a raised to n u of n. But here a is 0.2, so 0.2 raised to n u of n. So this would be valid for mod z greater than 0.2. This would be valid for mod z less than 0.2. Our question had this, so the answer was this. So in this way, you can analyze the question as well. Now let's look at the second question. So the second question we have is h of n is given as 5 by 6 raised to n u of n minus 5 by 6 raised to n u of minus n minus 1. And you have to find the ROC. Now, if you know the trick again, like what I said for less than, like for mod z less than some a value and for mod z some greater than some a value, correct? What is the rule? It would be for less than minus, it would be minus of a raised to n u of minus n minus 1, and here it would be a raised to n u of n. Now look at the question. The question is in this form here and in this form here. So what would be the ROC? Mod z less than 5 by 6. Mod z greater than 5 by 6. For C, for this part, it would be A is nothing but 5 by 6. So the answer would be this, mod z less than 5 by 6. Now see, A is nothing but here 5 by 6, correct? And so answer for this would be mod z greater than 5 by 6. So the region would be this, less than 5 by 6 and greater than 5 by 6. So this is the answer. I hope you are getting this gate question is nothing. It's just the trick you are applying and you are getting the answer in less than 30 seconds. So let's see one more question. So the third question we have is x1 of n plus x2 of n ROC is given as this. Then they are asking that what would be the ROC for x1 of n minus x2 of n. Now you are thinking this is a difficult question, I am not getting anything. Now look at the trick I have explained. Whenever you have to find ROC, what you are doing, covering the whole graph, correct? Now to cover the whole graph, you always require the poles, like this points are nothing but the poles, correct? So ROC is dependent only on poles, nor zero or nor this addition or negative sign, correct? They are dependent on poles, and these poles are from x1 of n, x2 of n, x3 of n, and so on. They are not like addition of this two, like subtraction of this two. Alright, they are only the poles from the respective function. So function 1, pole, plot this, respective circle. Function 2, get the pole, so this is the pole, respective circle. Alright, so I hope you are getting this point. Like ROC depends on the poles, and the poles are from the respective function and not like the addition of the two function, like subtraction of the two function. So the answer for ROC of this is this. So again, for this also the ROC would be, so since we know that ROC depends only on poles and not the addition of these two or the subtraction of these two, but the individual functions like x1, x2, x3. So the question has x1, x2, and they are asking again for the x1, x2, not like x1 and x3, correct? So for x1 and x2, the ROC was this. So again, if they are asking for x1 and x2, the ROC would be this only. So this was the tricky question where you have to understand that ROC depends on the individual function and not like the addition of the function or subtraction of the function. Now the last question in the ROC, which I have given the hard question, alright. So this is the question, x of n is given as 1 by 3 raised to mod n minus 1 by 2 raised to n u of n. Now this is hard because mod function is specified. if you know the concept, if you know the trick very well, you can solve this. So the concept was about the mod concept and the trick was about the ROC trick. Alright, so the options are given as such, 1, 2, 3, 4, these options are given. So let's solve this. So the first point is, whenever you talk about mod, mod means it would have positive in the positive side, it would have negative in the negative side. So mod value would be positive for u of n, mod value would be negative for u of minus n minus 1, that is for the negative side. Alright, so the answer is x of n would be equal to 1 by 3 raised to n for u of n, and it would be 1 by 3 raised to minus n, because mod value is negative for the negative side. So u of minus n minus 1, so plus, then we have this, that is minus half raised to n u of n. So this was the first step about the mod concept. If you don't know this, you cannot solve the rest question. So first point was about the mod concept. So this is the first step. Now let's talk about the second step. If you note carefully, you can get the ROC from this. Correct? So what is the ROC? You can see that this is a raised to n u of n. Now this is the positive, so it would be mod z greater than, because for greater than, this was the general equation like a raised to n u of n. So the answer would be 1 by 3. Now you have to note that it is, this minus should be taken inside, because we need a raised to n, this is a raised to minus n, we need a raised to n, take this minus inside, it would be 1 by 3 raised to minus 1, which is 3. So now it is in the form a raised to n u of something. So this is again the generalized equation like a raised to n u of minus n minus 1. Now this is for the mod z less than part, because for less than it, u of bracket would be minus n minus 1. Correct? So for mod z less than a, so we have 3. So now this, we have this again, mod z greater than 1 by 2, because for greater than, the equation is a raised to n u of n. Now this 3 are the ROC. Now from this 3 we have to determine what is the answer. Now to get the answer from this 3 ROC, you should know which combination is the correct combination. So if this 2 fits the combination correct, then you should know what are the possible ROCs for this 3 poles, like x is 3, x is half, x is 1 by 3. If you know the possible ROCs, then only you can decide from this 2 which one is correct. So the possible ROCs are, because we have to cover the whole graph, one ROC would be mod z is less than 1 by 3. One ROC would be mod z is greater than 3. But in question we don't have this greater than 3. So this won't be the case. So this ROC is gone. Mod z less than 3. So this is also not the case. So this is also gone. Now we have this 2. Like this 2 and this 2. Correct? So this 2 are only remaining, that is mod z less than 1 by 2. Do we have mod z less than 1 by 2? No. So this ROC is also gone. Now this ROC is only remaining, that is mod z greater than 1 by 2 and mod z less than 3. Is this combination we have, mod z less than 3, mod z greater than 1 by 2? Yes. So this is the answer and this is not the answer. So I hope you like the video.
So friends, agar aapko meri video pasand aa rahi ho, then do like this video, share with your friends and subscribe to my YouTube channel. तो मिलते हैं अगली वीडियो में. टिल देन टेक केयर. दिस इज श्रेनिक जैन. पीस आउट.